Hello, Kimball.
Hi.
Welcome to week three of Almost Christian Unplugged. We are so glad to be with you today. This song is a song called Home by Philip Phillips.
Yeah.
My middle name is Philip. Did you know that?
Oh, I had no idea. Well, right, Philip Phillip, double.
I am Michael Philip Phillip Jarbo. Can you imagine? That would be the weirdest, but not completely surprising.
Not super out there. I don't know. I feel like there's weirder names out there. And also, not surprising at all.
An American Idol winner.
Yes.
And Ken just did an incredible job covering this song. Was that you on the organ?
That was me.
A little action?
I know.
I didn't know. Ken, Steve and Distad, watch out.
Ken trusted me to play some simple stuff on the piano, which honestly was so fun and getting out of my comfort zone playing this song.
Yeah.
And I love singing harmonies, and I hardly ever get to do it because on Sunday morning I'm usually leading. And so any chance I get, I just love doing it. I grew up actually learning how to sing and singing harmonies in church, singing hymns with my grandma.
So
it's really fun to sing with Ken too, and he has that kind of folksy voice that really lended itself perfect to this song.
Yeah. Philip, eat your heart.
Khalil
out.
On the drums, the little kind of cajon drum mix that we've got going on, and always just bringing like a joy with his smile.
So the best smile around. So why this song? Why Home by Philip Phillips for our Almost Christian track? Again, I don't know Philip Phillips' religious background, but know that he was American Idol winner. He's got some good jams. This was kind of what the song that put him on the map.
Yeah, so it was like one of the biggest songs in 2012. It was even used for the Summer Olympic Games in London as
Look
theme
at those
song.
Stats, dropping stats.
Yeah, I mean, and let alone like this song just makes people happy.
It does.
I mean, it really does. And because I feel like on some level, we all believe in the power of home.
Mm-hmm.
And whatever home is to you, I feel like you can find it in this song on some level. And so, when I was thinking about music and what we wanted to do, I was just listening to a ton of music and this song popped up and I was like, oh, this song just makes me feel happy and the joy of home and like, what is home to me?
Yeah.
And so I thought we could have like some discussion on that.
Okay.
And I'm like, how, what is home?
How about for you? So what is home for you?
Yeah.
I think about the theology of place, which is like that what home doesn't have to be the house that you grew up in. In fact,
for
many
sure.
people, they have tough memories of home, and their home may have been the church. Their home may have been a friend's house across the street. Their home may have been some other spot. So what's home mean
for sure.
to you?
You know, and I think as I've grown through life, as I've become a mother, like I think that what is home is totally different for me than if you would have asked me 5 years ago or even like 10 years ago what that looks like. But, you know, right now, I mean, my kids and my husband are everything. And even, you know, our dog is like obviously a huge part of
little
that
pup.
As well. Yeah. And, you know, we travel a lot. We go around a lot. Like, I feel like we're also like just moving at a million different directions with young kids. And so I just find that sometimes when we are sitting down at the dinner table, we've started to turn all the lights off and like turn and just light a candle.
Mm.
And so it's dark and we just have a candle and we're all sitting down eating and like talking about our days. And I'm starting to find like that is the thing I seriously look most forward to in my entire day. Just like lighting that candle, us all taking a big deep breath and like praying and like really centering our time together. And, you know, I thought, my kids are young. Are they really going to get this? Like, is it going to really change the dinner vibe? Because I feel like dinner with young kids is literally wild. There's food flying everywhere. There's screaming going on. I cannot tell you. I feel like it's like centered and calmed.
Wow.
And we're able to like just really talk about some deep things.
There's some parents taking notes right now. Like, okay, great.
Well, even
candle.
I'm finding like we're praying and like my son is actually asking us questions about Jesus and like, I'm just being blown away by this just slight shift. And like that is becoming like what I'm seeing as like this is home right here.
I love it.
So anyway, that's kind of where I'm finding
that's
home.
Great.
What about you?
I think home for me, you know, it's fascinating. Like I'm about to celebrate being in Houston for 10 years. And it's like the longest place I've lived in since I was a kid. And I go back to, I'm a nostalgic person by nature.
Yeah.
So like when I go back to Dallas, I like to run to my hometown of Irving, little suburb of Dallas, and I weave through my streets and Leslie's like, are you good? And I'm like, yep, just doing my nostalgic tour and see all the places where I took my bike down into different alleyways and went to I run by my elementary school and my in my high school. And those places mean something to me. I know what happened at that corner. I know what happened down that hallway. And since my Leslie and I being middle school sweethearts, we have some really special memories of Irving.
Oh, yeah.
But it's not home anymore. You know, home is where people that you deeply love are. Home is, as a new homeowner, you know, establishing that.
Fixing the pipes and all the fun fixing.
Oh, my God.
The love and attention you have to put into that.
Exactly. It's like, oh, that costs more money than I wanted to give it. But it's all because I want to craft this beautiful place. When Leslie and I moved to Chicago so I could start seminary there, our first apartment, we just went a little above and beyond. And it was a little expensive out of our price range. And so, like, months in, about 5 months in, we had to move to another apartment that was smaller and less expensive. And I just remember, like, kind of crying because I had just done so much work to make this our home. I had painted the walls and made all these pieces to make it feel like a place for us. And I just realized as we got out of there, and it was, of course, Leslie who reminded me, like, home's not the apartment we were in. Home is just making it. It's because we spent so much of our emotional energy in that space. So emotional energy is a part of what makes home home.
Yeah, I love that. I love that. And, you know, as I was thinking through these lyrics a little bit deeper, they kind of give, like, 23rd Psalm vibes.
Okay.
A little bit.
Come on. Which part?
I don't know. Just like going as we roll down these unfamiliar roads, through these waves, and like, don't pay no mind to the demons. Mm. They'll drag you down, but don't worry, I got you. Like, I can bring you home. I just imagine like Jesus holding Philip's hand and like walking through life together and through the ups, downs, uncharted roads of life. Like, he's got you. And that, I don't know, that to me is also what like the 23rd Psalm is kind of about.
Right.
And so it's giving me those vibes.
That is such a good pickup. I think about it because we read the 23rd Psalm most at funerals.
Yeah.
And or celebrations of life.
It's all about coming home.
Right. It is, right? Because we do believe as people of faith that our home is temporary here. It doesn't mean we need to reject it and just say, like, I want to get to heaven as quick as we can. We have work to do here. I think Lent is that time most where we say, like, don't just flee earth. Do the best you can to follow Jesus and live out your faith. But also, we are reminded there is a great eternal home that we get to be in for the rest of our lives. I think about John 14, where it says, my Father's house has many rooms, and I've gone to prepare a place for you, and I will take you to be there with me. Like, that's a beautiful image just to know, like, our loved ones and even us get to find that home in heaven.
Yeah.
In this life after. So, like, little, like, this is eschatological. That's a big word for meaning, like, life after life. Like, this is, like, a beautiful song to take us there. Cool. I love your connection with Psalm 23. You're, like, kind of blowing my mind right now. You didn't give me a heads up of this. How dare you? But it's perfect.
Seminary who? Just kidding.
Oh, my God. Who's the real doctor now?
I don't know. I just like those like themes of home. Yeah. And then as I was just listening to it more, it just kept reminding me of the 23rd Psalm. And so I just thought those were like super cool elements to be able to bring to this Almost Christian series. Yeah. And I don't know, a lot of the music that I chose is about like searching and seeking, but like this one about coming home and just it's okay to also be happy and joyful and like, but resonate, and we talked about this last week, but like resonating in that sad and happy and like searching is fine too. But like this song just brought me joy, and I just wanted to bring that to everyone as well.
Know you're not alone, to make this place your home. Mm-hmm. That's good. Mm-hmm. This is a good choice.
Yeah,
a little 2012 in the house. What a year.
I know.
Where were you in 2012?
I was in college.
Oh, hello. me too.
Oh, yeah.
No, I was in seminary. Oh, my gosh. This song was going on when I was in that apartment in Chicago.
Oh,
wow. This is full circle moment.
Back.
I think I'm about to cry.
No. All right.
Perfect. All right. We should wrap it up on that note before both of us are crying. This has been great. I'm Michael.
I'm Kimball.
And thanks again for tuning in to Almost Christian Unplugged.